Today's rant's brought to you by The Home Theater Company. Audio, video, and home theater. Go online, hometheatercompany.com. Paging Rick Carlisle. Paging Rick Carlisle. You know that basketball team at Atlanta? The team that fired their great young head coach, Lloyd Pierce, on March 1st? The front office that you called insane for making that decision? Yeah, that team, the Atlanta Insanes. Guess what, Rick? They're four wins away from playing in the NBA Finals. And that great young head coach, maybe Mark Cuban should hire him. Seems like a perfect fit for me in Dallas. How about Atlanta? How about two road teams winning a Game 7 over the weekend? Let me start with the Bucks. Hey, I was wrong. I didn't give them any chance for going into Brooklyn winning a Game 7. I didn't think they could do it. I didn't think they had it in them. You know what? I give him a hell of a lot of credit. You know who else I give a lot of credit to? Kevin Durant. The guy was phenomenal. The guy carried the Nets on his back. And I'll tell you something else that I liked about Durant. Did you see him at the end of the game? Staying out on the floor? Being a real, true pro? Where the hell was that malcontent baby James Harden? You know where James was? He was walking off the court before everybody else after another miserable Game 7 performance where he made only 2 of 12 from the floor. That's right, that James Harden, who couldn't wait to get out of Houston, the malcontent, who was at a rapper's party in Atlanta while his team was at camp, had to be quarantined when he came back, was overweight, unprofessional, and forced his way out of Houston. You know what that's called, ladies and gentlemen? That's called karma. That's exactly what that's called. Because James Harden is now on vacation. He can do whatever he wants. He can go to as many parties as he wants. He can gain weight. He can do whatever the hell he wants. So you know what? I don't know about you, but I'm thrilled to death, and I really mean this, that the Nets aren't going on. But I gained an awful lot of respect for what I saw on Durant. All right, now let's get to Philadelphia. If your second best player can't put the ball in the ocean standing on the bow of a cruise ship, not going to work. This is the freaking NBA. You can't have guards that can't shoot. How do you have your second best player taken off the floor at the end of crucial games? Because he's a liability at the free throw line. I don't want that guy on my team. You're not going to win with Ben Simmons. Not going to happen. So here's Philadelphia out after two rounds. And guess who else is out after two rounds? That would be Doc Rivers. Yeah, I know Doc won a championship in Boston, but you and I could have coached that team. Kidding me? Rondo, Pierce, Allen, KG. Really? And again, I like Doc. I respect Doc. But Doc's overrated as a coach. I mean, couldn't do it in LA with the Clippers. Look at all those tremendous teams he had. Could never get out of the second round. Here he is with a team that should have beat Atlanta. And they don't. A lot of that's on Doc Rivers. Actually, more than a lot. It's a pattern. Right? How many chances do you get? But how about the Eastern Conference Finals? Who would have thought? Atlanta. The Atlanta Insanes. With Bogdan, I'm not good enough to play in Sacramento, Bogdanovich, Trae Young, and the rest of the Atlanta Hawks, coached by Nate McMillan, who took over for that great young head coach back in early March. Crazy world we're living in, isn't it? That's my rant for today. Hey, do me a favor. Hit that subscribe button. Let me repeat that. Do me a favor. Hit the subscribe button. I'm so freaking excited that Harden's not in the playoffs. I can't even freaking talk. Seriously. And I really like this rant, so I'm not going to go back and start it all over again. I'm just going to say, please hit that subscribe button. And if you like what I'm saying, give me a thumbs up. Leave me a comment. I promise I will do my very best to get back to you. Make it a great day. Thank you so much for watching Grant's Rant.